You see, you question only when you do not find something fitting in your patterns. Right? If everything is all right, you do not question it. You do not question why I am able to hear what you are saying. But if I am not able to hear what you are saying, then you will question it. Is that not so?
Yes.
So you question only when something does not fit in the pattern.
Yes, but why do we have the capacity of that?
Yes, we are coming to.
Yes, sorry.
So you believe the pattern to be real. And when the pattern is falsified, then you question. I believe that if I throw the ball, then it must reach there. And why must it reach there? Because I have always found it reaching there whenever I have thrown it. So this is a pattern. Huh? Throw it, find it falling. There. This is a pattern. Now if I throw the ball and the ball hangs in mid-air, then I will say, what is this? What's going on? Now there is a question. Yeah? So we question because we believe in the pattern. Hence, questioning can come only to a mind that has first known the pattern. But this mind has known the pattern but not seen the pattern to be false. So it starts feeling a little uneasy when it finds the pattern broken. It questions. There can be a mind lower than this that has not even seen the pattern. This mind will not question. It is such a dumb mind. A mind that is not even conscious of the pattern will never raise any questions. And you would have met minds like those, right? They don't question anything. Whatever may keep happening, they don't find any need to question it. Then there are those who question. Those who question believe in the pattern. And then there are those who say, pattern. It may continue or it may break. How does it matter? Just as a dream may continue or break. Continuation of the dream makes it no more real than a broken dream. Then they just sit in silence, they don't even question. We have all these three categories of people here also. Some are not questioning because they don't even see that what I am talking of is so disruptive. So they won't question. Oh, there is no need to question. It's all okay, much the same. Why should I question? There are some who are questioning. They are questioning because they are seeing that what I am saying is growing against the grain of what they have been believing. So they are questioning, they are asking repeatedly. And then there might be another category who is so absorbed, so immersed that it finds no need to question. A question is like a descent. A question says, the pattern must have continued. Why did it break? And if you have no affixation with the pattern, then you don't question. Then you are just silent and immersed. Huh? May there be more people like those here. But if you can't be like the one who is not attached to the pattern and hence does not question, then at least question. Are you getting it? If you can't let it come directly to your heart, if you find that the mind is standing in the way, then do express the resentment, the dissent of the mind. Then question. By questioning, you may probably come to a place where there is no need to question.